So a month ago, I reviewed the base M4 Mac Mini and its performance really surprised me, so much so that I spent most of the time after that review gaming on this tiny little box. Resident Evil 4, Firmament, Shadow of the Tomb Raider all run great, averaging 40 to 60 FPS at 1080p resolution and even 4K with Metal FX upscaling. But as you know, the Mac gaming library as it stands today is disappointing to say the least. That's when I installed a Windows compatibility layer over macOS through crossover, and man, now the gaming rabbit hole on the M4 Mac Mini gets deep. With crossover, I've been able to run Black Myth Wukong, Canon Strike 2, Diablo 4, and Stto Corsa, and some of these games run shockingly well. So this here is Crossover. It's a runtime emulator that translates executable codes into native codes. And what this means is we can open Windows apps like this one here directly from macOS without a virtual machine like Bootcamp. And in case you want to follow on and give this a go for yourself, I'll quickly run you through how this works. So once you've installed the Crossover app, you want to create a bottle by installing an application. An easy one to install just first is Steam. Once it's installed, I highly recommend using an external SSD drive so your Mac gaming library doesn't chew into your local storage. So you want to go into Wine Configuration, then into Drives, and format the C drive to the external SSD and make sure it's formatted as macOS Journaled, otherwise it won't be compatible with crossover bottles. So jumping into a Windows-only game like Canon Strike 2, I quickly realized that there's some tweaking that needs to be done to get it running smoothly. For starters, there's a fair few lines of launch options I've added to help optimize performance and push out as many frames as possible. These alone pushed out an extra 20 to 30 FPS. And secondly, your first few playthroughs with most games through crossover may be pretty rough as it caches the shaders, so you'll experience some significant slowdown. But maybe most disappointing, I can't use the Razer Death Adder V3 with this setup. I read that crossover doesn't play nice with mice that have a polling rate higher than 125 Hz, which isn't very high. The Death Adder here has a 1000 Hz default polling rate, and it doesn't track half the mouse movements in game. You can technically customize the polling rate on this mouse in the Razer Synapse app, but it's not compatible with Mac OS, and unfortunately, installing it via crossover doesn't work either. But playing on a PS5 controller works a treat though. And other than these issues, lots of games work incredibly well through crossover. Canon Strike 2 averages slightly over 60 FPS, peaking at 100 FPS on this base M4 Mac Mini at medium settings, VSync turned on, and at 1080p resolution. It's perfectly playable and it does look great. Just don't expect to be competitive. The input lag is really bad because the game is running through so many translation layers. A game that I couldn't believe I was running on a base Mac Mini M4 is Black Myth Wukong. This is a game that is resource intensive and also just a great game. I've sunk over 300 hours into this game. But yeah, running it at 1440p with low settings, it pushes out 30 to 40 FPS, but sometimes dipping down to 10 to 20 during big battles. There's a lot of artifacting and screen tearing, but crazy that this is even playable at 1440p on the base Mac Mini. I then tried Stto Corsa, and this was probably the best experience out of the games I've tested so far. Average FPS is a silky 50 to 60 FPS, even running at full native 4K resolution. And with most settings at high, this game just looks incredible and feels like it's running natively on Mac. The PS5 controller input actually feels pretty good as well and really responsive here too, and it's perfectly playable. But because these aren't native macOS titles, almost all these games, most of them required a bit of tinkering to work well. Like for Stto Corsa, you need to install additional programs in a very particular sequence. Like first it's Microsoft's .NET framework, then Visual CC, then Steam, and then Stto Corsa. And for Wukong, you'll need the Game Porting Toolkit 2.0, and D3D Metal and M-Sync enabled. And since these games run through so many translation layers, the base Mac Mini now coming with 16 GB is a godsend for running these games through crossover. 8 GB would just struggle. I haven't found the time to test emulators like RetroArch or PCSX2, but there's no reason the Mac Mini M4 isn't able to run most emulators. I have to comment on the Apple Studio Display 2. Awesome and beautiful display, as most of you know, but it's definitely not a gaming monitor. It caps out at 60Hz and has a native resolution of 5K, which is far too high of a resolution, even for the most top end of gaming PCs. You can downscale to a pure 2560 by 1440 resolution, but if you're serious about gaming, you should stick to a gaming monitor. So yeah, the M4 Mac Mini here with crossover is insane. I just can't believe that this $599 Mac is able to play AAA titles with a Windows compatibility layer over it. The base M4 chipset is able to push out some decent performance here. And so I can only imagine how great gaming could be with native macOS ports like Cyberpunk 2077 and Dead Island 2 coming soon. Let's hope that this is a taste of what's to come for Mac gaming.